Hello dear learners, in this module we will study about literature review, its meaning, definitions of literature review, need of review, sources of literature review, how to write literature review, how to read a research paper. Let's begin with review of the related literature. Review is systematic and organized compilation and critical study of the related body of knowledge. So before choosing your topic, you delve down into the related body of knowledge and you try to find out how much work has been done on a certain topic so that there might not be any kind of duplication of the studies. The review of literature comprises of two words, review and literature. So it's about reviewing the research literature that has already been conducted or been done. It can be said that review of literature is summarizing and synthesizing the previous researches done on that particular topic. Thus, review means to organize the knowledge of the specific areas of research in addition to your study. It is highly exhaustive, extensive, creative and tedious as the researcher has to synthesize and organize the material in unique way to provide the rationale of his study. Besides, the review of literature helps the researcher to identify the research gaps and to decide for a unique topic with unique objectives. Now let's study some of the definition regarding review of the related literature. Goodbar and Skates says the competent physician must keep abreast of the discoveries in the field of medicine. Obviously, the careful student of education, the research worker, an investigator should become familiar with location and use of sources of educational information. So that means as recent discoveries in the field of medicines are very important to any physician, so is the review of related literature to any researcher. With the help of recent reviews, it becomes very easy to identify the topic. It becomes very easy to identify the research gaps and it becomes very easy to set objectives for your study. W.R. Borge said, "The literature in any field forms the foundation upon which all future work will be built. If we fail to build the foundation of knowledge provided by the review of literature, our work is likely to be shallow and naive and will often duplicate work that has been done better by someone else." This already have been stated by me that review of literature prevents duplication of work. Now there is a question, why should we search for related literature? And here is the answer: to give direction to the research, to remain up to date in information about the literature, to avoid replications, to identify the research gaps, to know theories, ideas, explanation or hypothesis useful for the formulation of new problem, to acquaint yourself with the method, procedures, sources of data and statistical techniques. This is why we need review of the related literature. Now let's study about the sources of review of the related literature. From where do we get the related literature? First is books and textbooks. So books and textbooks are the very rich resource of the research works done because theories and knowledge is printed as such in the books. Second source of literature is periodicals. Periodicals are books, documents, almanacs, cumulative books, journals, magazines, etc., which publishes within a month, bi-monthly, it could be quarterly, it could be in 6 months, or it could be yearly. But these types of literature publishes within a certain period of time. The third rich source of literature review is databases. Now, databases can be categorized as national databases and international databases. The national databases are Shodhganga, Shodhgangotri, IndCat, Vidwan, ICSSR, in which you can get lot of related literature pertaining to your topic. International databases are Google Scholar, online journals like Elsevier, Bentham Science, Taylor and Francis, Walters Kluwer, Nature, etc. And fourth and the last, which should not be left over, is experience survey from your supervisor, which is the most important source of the review of literature. Your supervisor knows many things and you can use their knowledge as the source of related literature. Now, let's study how to write the review of the literature. The review of the related literature can be written in two ways. First is paragraph-wise and second is running text. So paragraph-wise is written as you can see on your screen. First, the surname will be written, and all here stands for many of the writers. So if there are more than two writers, then generally we write at all over here. So we write the surname of first author, who is prime author of that particular text, and then we write year in which the study was conducted within the parenthesis. And then we briefly describe what the study was all about, what was the sample size, how the research study was conducted, what were the results, conclusion. This all should be given very briefly within a paragraph. While writing review of literature paragraph wise, you have to take care that the next study you are citing should be in next paragraph. As I have written here, Deckard and Plomin, these are two writers and their surnames are written over here, and the year in which they have conducted the study, 2003, is within the brackets herein. Very briefly, we are going to state what was the study all about, what was the sample size, how the study was conducted, what were the results, and what essence you get from the study. The next is running paragraph. Writing the review of literature in running text requires merging of all the studies into a single paragraph. As you can see in your interface, the paper shows analysis problems faced by teachers and students during online education. And related to the same literature, the another paper, Suspending Classes Without Stopping Learning, written by Zhang et al. And same way in India also, a research study done by Goswami 2020, Online Education in Corona Outbreak, suggests that digital education has both positive and negative impact on education. Therefore, it needs to be geared up by providing sufficient internet accessibility. Now, this is something that we have to keep in mind. There should be some connectivity while you are writing the related literature in running text. There must be some connectivity, there must be coherence between paragraphs. Now let's study how to read a research paper. Reading a research paper requires a lot of cognitive work. So there are certain stages that you have to follow to get the essence of a research paper. I have divided reading a research paper into several stages. In stage 1, you have to get a feel. Getting a feel can be easily done by reading the title, abstract words, the words in bold, keywords, flipping the pages, and reading the bibliographic details and publisher details. This can be done easily while you are moving through pages. In stage 2, you get a bigger picture. Find for answers of the questions like, what is the research area? And that can be easily found in title or abstract. We can look for the answers like, what problem does the paper attempt to solve? Looking into title, introduction, statement of the problem. What is the related work and why is it not sufficient, or what are research gaps? Looking into introduction. What key contribution does the paper claim? It can be easily understood by looking into introduction and conclusions. Broadly, how does the paper solve the problem? By looking into introduction or figures. How do the authors defend the solution? By looking into introduction and figures. Thus, in short, title, abstract, introduction and conclusion can tell you all things. You don't have to waste a lot of time reading a research paper. Just looking into title, abstract, introduction and conclusion will solve your problem. The stage 3 is approaching to reading a research paper. In stage 4, evaluate the details like, is this research novel, significant, relevant, consistent? Are the graphs and figures logical and precise? This is how you can evaluate the details of the research paper. And in stage 5, you can synthesize all the details of previous 4 stages. You can ask creative questions like, what are the alternative approaches to address the research problem? Could there be a different way to substantiate the claim? Are all assumptions identified and validated? How can the results be generalized? What are the new ideas and open problems suggested by this work? So in this way, you can evaluate a whole research paper. Following the previous 5 stages, now you yourself can review a research paper, evaluate it and write the details precisely. Hope you will find this video interesting and useful for your research. Thank you so much.